Despite all she's been through, Kubra is one happy little six-year-old. She and her dad are from Istanbul, Turkey. They're staying at the Believe in Tomorrow House across from Johns Hopkins Children's Center, where on Monday she'll undergo surgery for a rare brain disorder.
We were in shock when we heard that she is going to have the surgery in America.
Kubra was born with a condition called moyamoya. It causes insufficient blood flow to her brain. She's already had two major strokes that's left her weak on her left side. She also has a rare congenital heart defect, and together it's a medical catastrophe her father was told couldn't be treated in Turkey.
We knocked every door that is possible for her disease, and we knocked every door for help.
Thanks to an anonymous donor, Kubra is getting help in Baltimore. She's had surgery to fix a narrowing in her aorta with a stent that instantly improved blood flow, reducing the risk of high blood pressure.
You can see that this area is very narrow, and after the stent is implanted, the area has been expanded and is as large as the rest of the aorta.
And that's a particular concern in our patient because she has these abnormalities of her brain blood vessels, which can rupture, leading to bleeding in her brain.
And that's something pediatric neurosurgeon Dr. Edward Ahn didn't want to see happen. To treat the moyamoya, Dr. Ahn says surgery Monday is designed to give the brain new blood vessels from a new source of blood.
There's a blood vessel on top of the skull called the superficial temporal artery. We isolate that blood vessel, and then we remove the bone and the covering over top of the brain and place the blood vessel on top of the brain. We're hoping that she can continue with therapy and restore that strength on that left side, but the main thing I want to prevent is a future occurrence of another stroke that will make her even weaker.
When Kubra first met her doctor, she told them two things about herself. First, she had moyamoya, and second, she was here to get better. Let's hope she does. At Johns Hopkins, Jennifer Franciotti, WBAL-TV 11 News.